Greetings fellow worldlings, welcome back to Wars and Wars, Joan of Arc. The previous time around that we left this game, we were essentially cleaning up the Loire River Basin, and this mission, the next one, is a continuation of the previous mission. In the previous mission we had to perform a siege on the city of Chateau, but this time around we will actually have to perform a siege on two different cities, or castles rather, one of them being, I think, Meung, and the other one being Beaugency or something. I don't exactly know how to pronounce it. Anyhow, let us go ahead and begin the fun. Mission 6 autosave. And yeah, alright, let's the siege of Meung and Beaugency. I don't know how to pronounce it in French, at least. Mission 6. The sieges of Meung and Beaugency. I'm just gonna call it Beaugency or Beaugency, who knows. And you never know how French names are gonna sound, to be honest. But to be honest, this level being a continuation essentially shares the map with the previous level, and I'm guessing that the only reason that it is so long, actually, the only reason that this was split into two levels instead of one, is so that either one, that the game wouldn't be as long, or two, that the game didn't have to load as many resources at any given point in time. However, I do believe this game has a method where it fragments the maps into smaller, more manageable pieces instead of just loading it all at once. Hence, you get those loading map screens in between while the map is still loading. Anyhow, most likely due to the length of how large that previous level would have been otherwise. It was still a pain, though.
I commend you on your brilliant effort in reclaiming Chateau for France. I realize that this was no small effort, and as such, I am assisting your cause.
Okay. As if that's a big deal.
I have brought along the creme de la creme of my soldiers for Meung. Do come and rendezvous with me immediately, for I am about to commence the siege.
Okay, that is indeed a big deal. Look at all those troops there. Although, I'm pretty sure that they're going to be wiped out by the time we actually get to Meung. Oh, okay, he's standing right in front of the castle of Meung. Okay, alright. That's understandable.
Yeah. This is good news, lads. Having Orleans buttress our plans to overtake the Loire will make life easier for us if we attack Meung together. Let's go now and head north to meet with the bastard.
I beg to differ. We should take the southern route. We will arrive much quicker. I'm sure that Orleans will be able to handle himself. If we both attack from the south of Meung, we stand a good chance of confusing our enemy.
Yeah, no.
I see. You're divide and conquer, eh?
We've got a job to do. Let's
do it on both sides. It matters not where we head. We are sure to succeed restoring peace in Meung with the bastard's help in hand. Now, let's see some English heads roll!
With the bastard's helping hand. Caravan is approaching Meung's Loire with weapons, supplies, and possible reinforcements. Stop them from reaching the castle. So I suppose here is where I use key number 6 or 7. Or maybe that's only like an RTS menu thing. Like, you can actually do that. Command the bastard of Orleans to do things. Yeah, right now I can't really do that. Oops. So, basically the first thing that I want to do here is hire some soldiers.
Ready to comply.
Ready be comply. Okay, shall we... Who do we want all of these guys to follow? Maybe Joan of Arc. Whoops.
Ready to comply. Ready to comply.
Maybe Joan of Arc for
Sergeant General.
Right then. Whoops. Totally messed that up.
Yes?
You sure the Mets?
Heading to destination.
Whoops, sorry.
Following General.
Yes?
Alright. Now, first things first, I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna hire more troops. Maybe I didn't need to do that.
Come on!
Okay, now what I want to do instead of getting like cheap folks is I want to get strong. I want, yeah, right here, heavy infantry. Because these guys, even though they're expensive, I do believe they will be worth it. Because these guys don't die off as easily. With that being said, the second my second order of business needs to be to head to this shop which sells bread. And buy as many provisions as I can. Because we're gonna need them. We're gonna need every single bit of provision that we can gather. And you guys can like literally tell that he's got a lot more provisions as compared to before. Okay, I'll leave it at that for now. And I'm just gonna open up my inventory and transfer a lot of my stuff to them. So that they don't die off as easily, essentially. This I'm gonna give to Jean de Metz for his own soldiers. Oh, that's how you do that. Okay, interesting. No, I did not want to do that though. Yeah, since I'm full, might as well give the other folks some things to deal with. Actually, I don't think... Lair does have... No, Lair does not have... He does actually have some troops under him. So might as well give him some of the stuff. And some apples, perhaps, for everybody. Since your energy recharges on its own, people don't really have much of a need for energy. It recharges on its own for the most part. Alright, we're back. Let's talk to you more. Did that guy say something about having no obligation to help me or something? Yeah, I can't sell this here. I'll have to sell this at the blacksmith's. Let's get more of this. Yeah, let's get everything that this guy has to offer. Okay, time to split it among our troops. So, yeah, I'll give this guy a few pieces of bread as well so that he can feed his own troops. And we'll split this as evenly as possible. I'll keep that for me. I'll give this guy some. And then some for this guy. A chicken for this guy. A ham for this guy. I'll keep another ham with me. And another ham for this guy. Now, I can't exactly place anything there, so I'll just leave these down here by the corner. Move this to a more suitable location. And we should be good to go for now. Let's just sort through these guys' inventories as well. Let's move this down. This guy has lots of apples and not a lot of items to heal himself. Yeah, I'll leave that in his own inventory. I'm mostly giving these guys supplies so that they don't die as quickly. In case any of them need any apples, this guy has some. But apparently everybody has apples, to be honest. I'll just put this in Joan of Arc's inventory because honestly she's not using a crossbow and I'm just gonna go ahead and sell it. Oh yeah, right. I can't exactly do that. I'll move this bread here because it restores more health than the smaller pieces of bread. Anything else that can be transferred here? Maybe one of these can be here. We don't exactly need that many of these. I don't think the troops can use these, but in case they do. English letter, I do believe. My dear brother Jean de la Baule. Your request for additional supplies has been granted by a king. As such, you can expect to encounter a large cache of arrow supplies stored in Saint Laurent Le Sommer. As the enemy is astute and is also in need of battle provisions, I urge you to exercise caution and send some of your stronger units to guard your supply of arrows and explosive arrows with utmost haste before the men of France reach them and make away with supplies that could very well aid us in overcoming the French threat and restore the status quo to the Loire River Basin. Your brother, William de la Pole. I don't think the English ever called themselves as de la Pole. I feel like they would have rather called themselves like just Pole instead of de la Pole. Doesn't make sense to me, but oh well. I'm just freeing up some inventory space for some of these guys by giving some of their apples to this here dude. Come here, fishy. Maybe some pieces of bread for his own troops. I mean, can't hurt, right? Alright. Let's stop this here, and... Yeah, we'll let his troops carry some pieces of bread as well. Not a lot of them, just some. But yeah, definitely let them carry something. Have you read this? As you're well aware, we have come in service of Votify Jago. I think we have read this. Unfortunately, scouts report that the enemy under the leadership of Joan of Arc is approaching a castle this time. And time is on their side, we have a slim chance to complete our fortifications in time. As supplies are nearly exhausted, we seek the presence of able units to help us finish the construction of guard towers surrounding the perimeter of Jago. It is the king's wish to see that Jago remains under the control of our superior English might, so it behooves all of us to meet our king's demands, brought to Jago to aid our woeful financial situation. Additionally, any supplies, be it elmwood, granite or iron ore, should be brought to Jago as well, so that we can finish our guard tower so that the king's wishes are met. Should you encounter French armies in the vicinity, do not hesitate to decimate their forces. I bid you all good fortune in your defense of the Loire. Yeah, we have read that. I think we have not read this. No, we have read this. Both of them were essentially the same letters. Now this guy here is the blacksmith and that guy there. And I'm gonna see what he has to offer. What he can offer. If he can offer anything at all, that is. Ooh. Duke of Alencon. Alright, so first things first, I'll go ahead and sell some of these. And this one as well, of course. That gives me barely enough to buy this for the Duke of Alencon. Okay. Only Joan of Arc may use this. Sword of Asian Code. Now, here's the thing. I think I might have missed this while playing. The game, I mean. Okay, let's give this to the Duke of Alencon. Let us put this on him. And does he have anything to sell? Leadership attribute, attack energy, attack damage, strength, dexterity, morale. I wonder what that does, to be honest. I'll just put this into the troop inventory, put this here. Seal of Antiques. Doesn't matter because, well, Bill's defense attribute, leadership attribute, let's hand this over to Joan of Arc so that she may sell it. Black Star Rupal, might as well sell it. Sell. And sell. I doubt this sells for anything. We can always try, right? We can always try. If it does not sell for anything, you might as well just sell it off altogether. Like, just drop it on the ground, to be honest. Okay. Gemstones. Somehow... Oh, sorry. Yeah, I have enough to buy the sword now. Beast damage 50, B attack 50. Imperial scroll. Cannot sell, cannot sell, cannot sell, cannot sell. Oh well. Now, I just want to quickly check, I sort of forgot to do this. 60 plus 30. 50, 50. Huh. Actually, Given the fact that I've got, like, a better equipment right here, I don't really think I need this. Should I hold on to this? These, maybe? I'm not sure. Let's just hold on to them for now. Okay, with everything out of the way, let us head towards... Where did we want to go again? Right, we probably wanted to head south. This way. Like, head towards Moon from the south side, apparently. Don't know what that entails, but yeah, that's what we planned on doing. Look at this gaping hole in the wall right here. Why is there, like, an entire army of soldiers standing there? Right here? Oh, these heavy knights. Right, I totally forgot to select them, didn't I? And they're not even assigned to anybody.
Yes?
Come on! There's a country to be saved! Come on!
Going there
there's
now.
A country to be saved!
So, basically, first they need to line up outside.
Yes?
We've going there now!
Let's do it!
Going there now!
So they're all Joan of Arc men, which is a good thing.
Come on,
so by default, they will be following her anyway. Cool. Okay, let's go. You guys following me? You better be. Now, carrying these all the way there would be beneficial, but I don't know if I should carry them or not. I could probably, like, ask two guys to man this, but dragging them all the way along with us would be a tall order, so let's just leave it right here. You guys with me? I sure hope you are. There's somebody stuck at the bread shop, but I'll just leave them be there. Oh wait, I could probably, like, I think some of them, yeah. Some of them did level up. Strength. Any attacks for you to learn? Of course, I'll, if you have an opportunity to learn an attack, I will help you learn it. Nobody is riding a horse, so no need to upgrade the horse attack. Alright, moving on. Okay, cool.
We've got a job to do. Let's do it.
Right. The map is loading. Sorry for the long ass preparation. Maybe I'll keep it in the game, maybe I'll remove it, because, I mean, this is certainly a part of the game, but I don't exactly want to bore you guys either, so let us see. Post-gameplay editing me will make that decision. We are marching our armies through these woods and forests. Last time around, we did clear out these areas of all the enemies. Hold up. Oh yeah, right. We did not capture that one village to our south. Maybe we should go and do that. Why not? Yeah, the fence has been removed now. So we should be able to take on any enemies right here.
We are approaching a forest. Careful, lads. Enemies are bound to be lurking under the canopy within.
I can see one right there. I could see the silhouette of one of those guys somewhere along the forest route. There's like a tomb right there. Archers! I was too busy focusing on his health bar and totally forgot to check when he healed over and fell down. Shall we? I mean, I can hear battle sounds, but nobody's actually coming to fight me. I can get that guy from all the way here. So, the first thing that I'd like to do is eliminate archers. Makes the job a lot easier. When you actually have to fight people, I mean. I'll stop wasting my arrows. Looks like the battle's on then. Oh, okay. Jean de Luxembourg. Ah, so predictable of you French to unwittingly stumble upon such a trap. Please come closer so that our bombards can have a good close look before they decimate you and your forces. Oh no! The town and all those that had the misfortune of to have lain my path shall forever belong to England. I will personally see to it that the status quo remains rightly so. Status quo. I did not think they used to use that term back then. But that's a very recent term. But the bombards, we need to do something about the bombards though. And that is a certain. As soon as I can locate them, I'll do something about them. I mean, if these guys are not going to react, I might as well nail them with what I have. I'm surprised though that I did not get a chance. I actually bought the level 3 bow, I just don't know where it is. I could have sworn I had it. Okay, this guy again. Because why not? That guy. Sorry for the lackluster gameplay, but I'm just trying to keep my odds in my favor and my troops alive. Alright, saving here. Next section is going to be a little difficult, so I'm just going to switch over to these arrows here. Because we're gonna have to strike the bombards down. Where are the other bombards? Right there. Those were just the only two bombards in the area. There are so many arrows flying all over the place that I can hardly tell what's going on. And more importantly, where is going on? Somebody struck me down. Holy shit, you guys need to die. How are you guys still alive? Why are you still alive, more importantly? Actually, should have just gone ahead and done that to begin with. More archers there. These guys are literally standing around in ranks and files, to be honest. Holy shit, that is a lot of archers. Is that guy down? Yes, he is! These accursed French have injured me. I shall have to retreat in order to fight another day. Good. And time to decimate all of these archers instead. Good thing that they were standing like this, because otherwise, it would have been difficult to take them on. Look at all these archers. I mean, that is what the English were known for, the longbows. But still. when I see them like this, it sort of is a little overwhelming. And I suppose that was the idea, to just overwhelm the enemy. Okay, that got those people are down. Let them go around and kill the remaining archers then. Didn't need to do that for that guy, but I just did it anyway. Come on, move out of the way. We found a fish, among other things. Lots of archers here. A lot of archers. My god, why are there so many archers here? Let me just go ahead and disable all the archers from range, so that my own troops have a fighting chance. Hi. He never stood a chance, did he? Oh yeah, right. I can't go in like that. More enemies around the area. Cool. These guys are just got surrounded. I'm sort of surprised that our troops are having an easy time in this fight. I wonder if it's because our generals are all leveled up and all our troops are properly well fed and everything. So where are the rest of these guys that need killing? I see some here. Oh, there's a chest there. Alexandrite diamond. Okay, strength can decrease in the enemy's damage sustained during melee combat. Decreases damage sustained in melee combat by 15%. Okay. Bearer's dexterity, bearer's weapons damage, fighting rate of weapons. Let's put this here and bring this here. Okay, our troops are at the brink of death. Judging by the amount of food we have left. Have we still not managed to... Ah, you guys. So there are some of you guys still alive, huh? I'll give this all to Lair, because he can definitely use it. He can find more use for it, as compared to me, I mean. Liberated. North side, south side of Loire. Alright, we'll get to it. Hail, O most valiant saver of all small village. Since the English occupied the entire Loire region, we have had misfortune to live under the shadow of our vile captors. Now we are once again free. No benefit has graced us during this period of chaos, but there is much for you to gain, as we frequently overheard the English talking amongst themselves. I believe I have information that may assist your endeavor. I just randomly talked to this person and she has information for me? Damn. From what I have overheard, Meung appears to be some sort of containment facility for many riches that the enemy has stolen and looted from us. I have witnessed myself more than one cart carrying crates full of gold leave our town. Beaugency, on the other hand, conceals many English, but despite their appearances, they are not ordinary soldiers. They were brought in from lands afar to conduct special tasks. Special forces, I see. Unfortunately, I know nothing of their nature. Perhaps on your journey towards the castle, you may be more successful in discovering their secrets. Alas, I know not more. I bid you the best of luck, gentle warriors, and may the grace of our Lord forever shine upon you. Vive la France! Alright, quick saving. So every village that you save typically has something for you to pick up. Okay. Alors, I'm happy to see that the French forces are alive and well. Please, before we part ways, allow me to inform you about a peculiar incident I saw a few moons ago. Should you venture past the castles of Meung and Beaugency, there's a house with an English unit. What struck me as odd about this fellow was that he was chased out of Beaugency by his very own people. Okay, that is indeed of value. I thought you might be interested in this piece of news. Now that is something that I would definitely love to check out, because it could be a sign that that house comprises of a turncoat, essentially. And in that regard, well, I want as much help as I can get. That was nice. Now you guys are gonna get pummeled. All the way to death. Come here. Time for you to meet the same dude, as your cousin said. Flouter. Only heavy attacks hit them while they're down on the ground, not by attacks. That's why I like doing heavy attacks. Plus, they like cover a broad area and they will down every single person that they can down. Heavy attacks, I mean. Okay, that seems to be like a band of crossbowmen. Let us go ahead and use the last few explosive arrows that we have to close the distance. Alright, cool. Okay, we need to...
Critical. Critical.
Where do you think you're going? Good. You're gonna get swallowed up soon. Narrow passes means that numbers don't really mean a lot. So... Here's the thing, you can try and fight in these narrow passes all you want, but the enemies don't always follow you into them, I mean. Time to weaken the horde. Oh wait, I don't have any more arrows left. Good, you can block. I can block too, but I don't like to waste my time doing that. I love watching these guys get swallowed up. We also do have some infantrymen, so in case we need to man some cannons, we can do that as well. I mean, we could always just go ahead and find more people. Let's switch over command to... Maybe Lair.
Ready! Following General!
Yes? Following General! Yes? Following General?
Yes?
Alright. Let's have Lair take over control, and those are explosive bolts. We will keep them for later. This is, I think, a long-range crossbow. Right. A level 3 weapon. I wonder when he's gonna get an upgrade for this. If at all. If ever. Maybe we can... take one bread and put it in her inventory. And have her... Yeah, she'll take care of her own health. Hopefully everyone will be following us. Into battle, I mean.
The enemy has spotted us. Prepare for attack.
Okay, oh, loading map, right. That actually played out in my favor. I actually don't typically like playing with this guy because he's slow. He's very slow. This guy's very slow. Extremely slow. And we're lagging. For whatever reason. Never thought that I would be lagging playing a game that was released in 2004. But here we are. And that, I do believe, is the castle of Moon. Now, what I want to do is... Or is it? I just want to quickly check what castle this is, excuse me. I can see a field cannon right there, though. Which is a little concerning. Mission briefing, I want to see the battleground. Okay, 2D view. Okay, so this is essentially where we are. This, I'm guessing, is the castle of Moon, probably. And this might just be the castle of Beaugency. Now, I want to find out where this place is where we wanted to go. Maybe we should head back, liberate this village, go through the city, liberate these villages here, recruit more people as we can manage to do so. And that seems to be the Bastards of Orleans. I would prefer to attack the castle from here, but there's also this little place that the hut in the woods. Maybe they're talking about this one. We can try and find out which hut that is. I would like to liberate this village. I don't know whether I should, because it's like a detour and not really a winning condition for this game. I mean, once the French have a good stronghold on the map here, they can always go and liberate villages at will, I feel like. Let me just go ahead and... not strategic command. There was another townships, right? Beaugency, yeah, that's Beaugency, okay. That's Blois, that's Bouges, that's... those are all under English command. That is sad. Chessy, Fontainebleau, Janville. Oh, I missed one. Oh no, we've actually never been there. Jago, Losches. We just liberated that. Meung, that is Meung, right? And that would be Montargis, Orléans. Bate, Ravi. Yeah. Oh, all the way there. Saint Florent le Sommer, isn't that where we were told to go? No, I think it was Selzenberry. Saint Agnar, Tours. It's either that one, but she did say beyond, that woman did say beyond Meung and Beaugency, so I think it's this one. So yeah, let's go and go there. Sorry for the flickering, the game does that. We're just gonna ignore them and head straight for these guys. Okay, you guys go swallow them. Meanwhile, I'll take care of these guys here. These crossbows have range. I like that fact. Where do you think you're running? You got caught up by Lair's attacks, of all people. Alright, you guys better move. I'm trying to get somewhere. This seems to be a scroll of some thought up ahead. There's like a little track here. Oh, it's one of those places, right? See, this is what I dislike about Lair. The fact that he can literally get
critical attack
interrupted by enemies. And it's sort of a sandwich between my own troops and the enemies in between. So this is a place where you can get stuff for making, you know. Let me go ahead and use my crossbow as much as I can. Get rid of the pesky archers first, because these guys will interrupt your attacks like anything. Wait, those guys are swallowed up? Holy shit. That was insane, man. Hurry, the enemy has reached the vicinity of Beaugency. We must prevent them getting any closer.
Let us rid ourselves
of the evil enemy, said Lair. That guy said. Okay, time to pull out the explosive bolts again. Whoops, that's not it. Right here. Good. Who the fuck are you guys trying to flank here, huh? Exactly what are you guys trying to do? Flank the opposing army with such inferior numbers? That's not what you're gonna do. That's a stupid ass move. I can see another enemy right there. I don't know where they are though. I can just see them on the map. There's supposed to be somewhere right over here. Oh, there you guys are.
Don't
case my foot. Okay, that guy has a strong stomp. I'll give him that. So, before I begin the siege on this castle, of course, we will have to take these guys out. Okay, we must warn Lord Talbot that the enemy is encroaching on our territory. I mean, if you guys want to flee, go for it. I'm not going to stop you, but, okay. Okay, we're back to normal arrows. No fancy arrows anymore. Let us get rid of the English archers there first. Did not see that guy firing at me. Okay, that is enough. We do not want to go all the way there. We first want to check this guy out. I'm guessing this is another place where you can make siege weapons. Yes. Alright. This hut right here.
This must be what the kind man in Loches was talking about when he talked of special English units.
Eldia Tinker? What is this? Dragon Natatia? This guy's a standing guard. Nice cutscene, isn't it? French soldiers, do not attack. I am no longer at one with the English. I see that you are a French general. Spare my life and I shall make it worth your while. You see, unfortunately, I was discovered stealing some valuables within the city of Beaugency. My actions angered my commander, who ordered me to be put to death. If not for my hasty escape, I would not be here talking with you. In exchange for my life, I can perform a task that would prove very useful to you. I knew Meung well, having served there prior to being reassigned to Beaugency, where I, shall we say, fell from grace. As such, I can help you gain entrance to the city, but the risks are high, and therefore I must ask for a compensatory sum of 3,000 gold. Thankfully, I sold all this stuff. 3,000 in gold before I risk my life by revisiting, shall we say, the Lion's Den. Fine, I shall leave immediately and inform once my deed is done. Wearing my English uniform, I shan't have much trouble entering the town. And as I've just trimmed my facial hair, I doubt that anyone will recognize me. Attaboy. Where's this old man heading? Hold up, I want to talk to you. I thought this day would never arrive. It is good to see that our troops are expelling the enemy forces. I have some good news for you, brethren. Word has arrived that General Arthur de Richemont will be arriving soon. When, I do not know. But I can tell you that he is expecting some action when he arrives. Dragon Natatia, huh? He has instructed me to hand his package to you when we meet. Until then, there are some provisions laying nearby in the town. Please feel free to make use of them as you see fit. Good luck to you all when you approach Beaugency. Yes, first we need to liberate Meung though. Hematite Bloodstone. So you can get some stuff, cool stuff from these guys when you talk to them. Alright. Now shall we switch over command then? For Meung, let's go with... Yeah, let's have them all follow.
Yes?
Where is this guy, Jean de Metz? Like, what the hell? Where is this guy? I can't even tell where he is.
Yes.
You know what? Let's just... Oi, you there! Raise the gate and allow this fellow soldier entrance. Alright, mate. Hold your horses. Alright now, I've opened the southern gate and damaged the gate mechanism. It will take the English many days to repair the mechanism. Okay, I want you to move right there.
Yes? Following general!
Yes? Yes? Following
you follow
general.
Him?
Yes?
Yes?
And you also
following
follow
general.
Him. Not that, I did not mean to do that. Where's Chantemets? Right here? Yeah, that's right. That's
following general.
Yes.
Just give me a second there. If we actually select some other guy. Hold up, thank you. Ooh, shit. Okay, we need to move. Retreat, man, retreat. The enemy is heavy upon us. Those men are lost, leave them be. Head to me. So yeah, if you actually select somebody else after assigning them to follow somebody, they just stop following them when you reassign them, or rather when you stop using them. So yeah, that probably a bug, most definitely a bug, but that is what happens. Almost glad that those guys who took it deep were essentially newbies, but still, I was hoping that they would survive the encounter. Okay, we have some bread to share with our soldiers. Might as well put this here. No use of this bread for us. Takes two of it to restore our own life. No, I do not want you to hold, I want you to follow me. And these long breads and these fish and everything are more or less just wasted on our troops. So might as well keep this here, to be honest. Makes for one less healing item, but well, as long as it works, I suppose. Let's keep that equipped for now. They've already cleared this area out now to start the siege of Meung. Now if we play the game the way the game wants us to play it, of course you do. The wagon has arrived. Raise the gate, lads. Oh no. Why did the game hang up all of a sudden? I'm guessing it's loading at this point in time. Okay, I accidentally missed a line of dialogue there. With the war going against us, it will not hurt if we have a surplus of gold to count on, and the standard King Henry will send more troops our way.
It seems the English are intent on taking our nation's riches to use for their own depraved needs. We must stop them.
Well, we are going to capture the castle anyway, sir.
What are we waiting for? Storm the gates!
Monks flanked by towers, beware of enemy missiles.
Roger, roger. Okay, so first off, I need to destroy the obelisk. Okay, cool. Now head back, come back to me. Do not engage the enemy. Oh well, I guess it's too late already. I guess this is on. Amid like a whole storm of arrows at that. Exactly what I did not want, but oh well. Can't help it. Let's go ahead and craft like a siege cannon and bring it back. I hope they will be following me back. Retreat! Everybody retreat! We need to build some siege cannons, and for that purpose we are retreating. Duke of Alencon, with me. Come here. We can bait those guys to us. That will make it easier to fight them. Our troops? Yes, our troops. Joan of Arc, come here. Like, if those guys are headed towards us, it'll make the fight just that much more easier. No, I feel like they're all our troops. Huh. Oh well. At any rate, we need to switch over to the Duke of Alencon. Not that guy.
job to do. Let's do it.
Yes. So let us build a trebuchet. We do have like a 10,000 wood right now. And yeah, I suppose
building
we can
siege weapons. Siege weapons built.
Just to take out three light infantry are required to operate this.
Ready. Ready.
Okay, let's select them like this.
Ready to comply. Manning siege weapon. Ready.
Okay, why don't you guys start off by moving to location, and
we need more units.
What? Really? I thought you took like three light infantry.
We need to save our lands, not stay idly by. We need more units.
Really? I thought you could have done without more units.
Already. We need more units.
How about
we you? Need more units?
I thought you did not need more units.
Ready. Unable to comply.
Yeah.
Ready.
Oh well. I guess those three are assigned to the to that thing now. Anyway. I just hope that the Duke of Alencon will be following us now. Apparently not, he's just stuck there. Alencon.
Yes?
You need to come
following
follow us.
General.
Oh no, that is not what I wanted to do.
Yes. Ready!
Yes? Following General.
Yes, you need to follow him. This guy just blocked an arrow flying through the air. Okay, let's head to the back of the area first. You think you guys are the only ones who have arrows? I've got arrows as well. I've got arrows for days. At any rate, what I want to do first is, practically, let's daze the enemy a little, harass them with arrows. Now what I want to do next is bring this goddamn siege machine here.
Ready.
I hope it can traverse this narrow path. If it cannot, then well, we are in tough
luck.
We
need more units.
Apparently, you can't go there. That is a waste. I suppose we can use them for Beaugency, but not for this one. Oh well. All right, gentlemen, commence attack. Commence your attack upon these heathens. Okay, we are totally out of exploding arrows. Time to switch back to these. I just got struck down by a hail of arrows. And the sound is glitching out again because of the sound of arrows flying through the air. And when I say glitching out, I mean I cannot hear shit. At least these arrows don't really cause that much damage. And thus far our army is being successful. Thanks to the English. Thanks to... yeah, pretty much the English.
You're a dead man.
Who got their own... who essentially kicked their own man out. We were able to turn one of the people who helped us in conquering this castle. You arrogant fools, you think you can just waltz in here and destroy everything we have fought hard to claim from you? Ha! Huh. Over my dead body. I see they were pretty... they used to follow the means back then as well, did they? Fuck, move, you bitches. I need to get ahead of the pack and give you guys some support. Disrupt the attacks of the archers, because they will be the death of you. Ah, you have arrived to your northern side of defense. Why is it that the arrows are hitting? fox is what I'm trying to aim for, the enemies right here. Now with the aid of
critical attack.
Okay, copper. May you die a peaceful death. Copper, his name is Copper. Not even Copper Bottom or anything. Just the Copper Metal. That was a total miss. Okay, our troops. We need to feed our troops. Since bread is all we have, bread is all I'm giving them. Yeah, give it to your troops, sir. Give the bread to your troops. They need it. Alisson, troops, feed your troops. Troubadour. Por favor. Whoops, not what I wanted to do at all. Joan of Arc. Alisson. Yeah, give bread to your troops. They need bread. I thought I just gave you some bread. I guess not. You should eat something. Yeah, thank you. Open any gold chest to reveal its contents. Doesn't really matter to us. Your troops need bread. They need to remain alive if they are to see the enemy through to the end of the battle. I sort of want to quick save there, but I know that would be foolish, so I'm not going to do that. The leg of the ham, and our forces have already been dwindled. You're almost dead, and you will be almost dead as well. Now to gangbang this guy until he gives up. Alexander, he's not William, so he will not die in this encounter. But yeah, he will definitely be defeated. That is for certain. So this is essentially what makes these levels difficult, the fact that all of these archers are just raining down hellfire upon us. Oh, more archers for me to harass. I picked up a smoked chicken. Why is the game lagging so hard? And where is the Duke of Beaugency? What the hell is he doing? Like, seriously. Why is he not helping us? I may have just brought more trouble our way. Where do you think you're going, William? Alexander! Stand and fight! Okay, I need to heal.
Critical attack.
Okay, Alexander sound. Regent Bedford? Holy shit, what the hell is this guy? No, my dear friend has been slain! No, my dear friend has been slain! I shall avenge your death, de la Pole. Pole, call him Pole. You whelps of sewer dogs, come and feast me at the barracks if you have the call. I shall tear you limb from limb, said the fat man in the bulky suit of armor. I tried double jumping up the stairs. I don't know why I did that, or why I thought that would work. And our troops have been decimated, primarily because of the rain of arrows. So you can enlist as many troops as you want to, but most of them are going to end up dying, and it'll mostly just be you and your generals conducting the fight in most cases. Moved just in the nick of time before the arrows hit me. I mean, 2100 XP. Lair, I saved your ass. Not a word of gratitude in return. Not a single word? Oh well, I guess some people are just born in woods. I'll leave you to handle that car. So, first order of business that I will do next is, since that is done, instead of facing all these guys at the ground, I'm gonna head up there and I'm gonna start taking out the archers. Because these guys are the real menace. There's gonna be like an entire volley coming my way.
I need help to.
No, you don't. Don't worry, you're all fine. That's not going to go. You're fine. You've got health items.
I need some help here.
I'm being attacked.
You are?
Idly by.
You guys have stuff to eat, right? Well, you guys could. Use some more stuff to eat, that is for certain. Let's distribute some more things for you guys. Otherwise you might just keel over and die. Because I seem to have hogged all the food. Kept it for myself. Alright. Let's head inside. We can just rest here for a while. I know I can, at least. Ah, this is the way up.
I'm too fast for you.
You are?
Quickly diminishing.
I'm too fast for you. I'm too fast for you.
How many strikes does this guy require to die?
I'm too fast for you.
Critical attack.
I need assistance!
Wait, I can use this? Can I like use this? Oh no, I probably need to head into RTS mode or something to use it. Okay, this guy leveled up again. The Duke of Alencon is being greened right now. Since that area is clear, I honestly don't know where these guys are, but they also seem to be right here. He's probably getting pummeled by arrows or something. They have no idea where they are. Oh yeah, they're right here. They're probably fighting down there. No? Okay. Now that that's done, let's take care of these archers here. Anything to disrupt your attacks, keep you from attacking, basically. Can you rescue me? I would love to.
Many of our fellow citizens are trapped in cells among.
I guess we need to get arrows, the keys for those cells. Okay, explosive bolts. Oh wait, only Lair may use them. Let's just assume command of him for a second. What help could she possibly be there yet? Automatic crossbow.
I'm being attacked.
Feast on this.
I need help to fend off the enemy.
Oh,
you're fine. You're okay, Joan of Arc. You're okay. Or are you? No, you're okay. You're fine. It's been dramatic as well. Too bad you can't block arrows. If only you could, huh? If only you could. Now he has got a lot of health, so it makes him the ideal tank to charge down ranged enemies like these. Pretty much the reason why I've got... Please free me. I would love to, but I do not have the keys. Joan of Arc does have a key, but that key is only applicable for... apparently. Why the fuck are you guys there? Oh well, whatever suits your fancy, I suppose. It's strange, I can't head down this way. I do believe it was Jean de Blatz, yes. This part is blocked. Why don't you guys come here? And we'll just enter the moats of this place, like this castle. Or what seems to be the moats. That was a nice finish. We'll get this guy first. Clean. Clean. Now, yeah, looks like we can't exactly enter there. Can't exactly open those either.
Not a dead man.
Almost. He was almost a dead man. So the key to winning encounters in this game is to just keep moving. As long as you keep moving, the enemies will know how to hit you. Picked up a prison key. Alright, come here, let's go. Team, retreat. Okay, maybe we can just go from that side. What's up? In either case, I want to be taking like a full circle.
Take that. You're a dead man.
Not quite. Yeah, now he's a dead man.
Take that.
I got stuck between an enemy and a tree. Not quite a rock and a hard place, but something similar. Lair is getting double time. Cool. Sometimes you just need to be patient and let them get up instead of spending all your energy on ninja attacks.
Critical kill.
The four generals on their own are enough to apparently subdue an entire enemy force. This is not where I wanted to come. Let's retreat for the time being. On me, people, on me. Maybe this is... No, no, no. So I guess that is the strategy, to have them have our troops flank. Oh man, that resounded like anything. Picked something up. I just picked up a key. I don't know to what, but I did pick up a key. Now here's the thing, I want to go back and release those poor folks from the prison, being the reason why I'm headed back that way. Seemingly the Bastard of Orleans is also putting up a fight. I don't know how much of a fight he's putting up, but he is putting up a fight. Quite certain though that the brunt of saving the other guys rest on us. Thank you. May your efforts lead to triumph. Well, I certainly hope so. Recruited two prisoners. What? Wait, I do not have the key to open the lock. Shit. I thought I just had the prison key, or was it like a one-time use thing? Okay. Yeah, it was a one-time use thing. It is strange, to be honest. Yeah, give us your stuff. You don't need that. So maybe you do, who knows. Oh, yeah, right. Maybe I can command like the Duke of Alencon right now.
Yes.
Why don't you, Duke of Orleans, why don't you just try and, like, wherever you're standing, right? Like, since you're standing there, why don't you actually come and, begin your assault on these troops here?
Going now.
For France!
Yeah, instead of just standing there, why don't you begin your assault on those troops? Whoops. Now, I won't see for a while. Alright, now another thing there. I'm gonna grab all of these people and I wanna change the leadership to the Duke of Alencon.
Following General!
Okay, Duke of Alencon.
Following General!
Yes?
So it looks like they've started fighting. Which is always a good sign. Enemies fighting is always a good sign. Oh yeah, some people did level up as well, right? Whoops, not that. I keep forgetting the keys for... Yeah, let's level up your health. Push it to 200. Yeah, let's push that to 50. Dexterity, defense. And let's pull the rest of the defense. Energy attack. Now that is something that I would love to loot. Oh hey! She has agreed with as well. Let's push that to 40. And maybe 1 point to health. She does not have an energy attack unlocked yet. Oops, you have can't exactly level that guy up. Should not have quick saved there, but oh well. We'll try and save that guy if the need arises. Duke of Alencon. We're essentially feeling bulls right here.
Critical.
This guy doesn't really have all that much range to his strikes, despite using a halberd.
I need help to fend off the enemy.
You do?
Critical attack.
Yeah, I did that and played my part pretty softly here. That guy was fleeing towards me. May you die in peace. Cool. There are more people there, but I would just like to go get down into the moat first, lead the enemy to me, instead of going towards the enemy myself, where they have an advantage. I hope those two can unglitch themselves. Good. Explosive arrows. All I really wanted. Okay. Time to equip this then, since that is the only thing that we have anymore. None of those guys are dead yet. Otherwise I would have heard the chime. I don't know where Lair is coming from. He's like taking this seemingly large circle around the attack base. This guy's really confusing. It's like he has this very specific range of attack. Picked up another key. We don't know what that key does. We just know that it is a key. Okay, time to go hit those guys there. Ultimately, we do need to kill every single person on the map, so this works out for us as well. Not that big of a deal, to be honest. Just going from the outskirts first.
Don't go away.
Ooh, this guy leveled up.
Don't go away.
All right.
Don't go away.
Ooh. Now for these guys. Andre.
Don't bother getting up. Don't bother.
He said don't bother getting up. I like this guy's lines.
Don't bother getting up.
Deputy personal, so to speak.
Don't bother getting up. Don't go away.
Don't go away.
Don't bother getting up.
Alright. With that out of the way, I suppose we can just head into the inner circle from here. Or so, I suppose. Well, what about the bastard of Orleans?
Yeah.
So the bastard of Orleans.
Yeah.
Oh, this guy's literally stuck there.
Going now.
To the attack!
For France!
Yes, good. On the mats. Yeah, but I don't exactly want to place that guy.
You need help to send off the enemy.
You do?
Don't go away.
I told you not to go away. Where the fuck do you think you were going, son? Prison key. Good. Now I want to go back there and unlock those people, but my god, it is such a roundabout way to go, you know? Oh, treasure chest. Let's take care of these guys first. You know, I was actually genuinely expecting the bastard of Orleans to help us out in this mission, not just stand idly by with his dick in his hand. But that is exactly what he did. Stood idly by with his dick in his hand. I do not possess the key to open this box. Oh, there he is. Oh, we're getting flanked.
Don't go away.
I was too late. This guy woke up.
Don't go away.
Cool. Okay, just cool. Okay. So where is... Why is this guy all the way here? Oh, right. We need to order him to follow. Wait. No. Prison key? No. Prison key? Yes. Let us have him unlock them from the prison then. Duke of Alencon. This is the way to go, right? I feel like it. Feel it is. I don't know though. It's like every person has found one of those keys that opens like a treasure chest. I don't know which one to open. Maybe let's open this one. Well, we only had like a fair few options right there, and I feel like we used up most of them.
At your orders. At your orders.
Following General.
Good. Follow the Duke of Alencon. Why the fuck are you sitting around? Do something about it. Your armor, I mean. Well, that is where we've been told to go, but... Cool. The fat guy, I guess, yes. Regent Bedford, you offspring of a woman of ill repute. Really? You're calling a guy the bastard of Orleans? Why? Pull your punches right now. Why are you insulting this guy like the French? Come on, you're the English. This is very simple. Just stay still while I crush your skull. You shall not feel much pain as your end will come all too quickly. You will be destroyed for killing my dear comrade. What are you, English or Russian? Decide that first. Of course, if you choose to say, I will be forced to use my mighty hammer to plaster your face all over the walls. So I need to defeat Bradford in a one-on-one duel. Holy hell! I thought it was supposed to be a one-on-one duel. Well, I guess my own troops didn't really listen to me either. I guess none of them really got the memo, and they started attacking Bradford just like that, without anybody consulting anybody. So I guess it's all fair. Are you? Joan of Arc? Are you? Okay, let me just take care of the knights, and I'll be right with you. Okay, Joan of Arc should not die. She has enough food, to be honest. This guy, however, needs some food. This guy, too, has enough food. Okay, everybody has enough food now. These boats can go to Loire. Quartz crystal. It's honestly the same thing. Does not really matter. Maybe let's give that to the Duke of Alencon instead. I love it when that happens. Now, we just move away.
Your health is quickly diminishing.
Okay, that was a heavy, heavy attack. Yeah, Venice moves get...
My health is waning,
my health
man.
Is faltering.
You guys have stuff to eat, right? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I wonder why you're not eating it, though.
I need assistance.
No, you don't. Stop being such a wuss. Move out of the way. You don't just surround that guy and fight him the way you are doing. That is a sure shot way to your own destruction.
I need some help here.
Yeah, go get him.
My health is quickly diminishing.
I was honestly backstepping, but apparently that was too late. Ooh, landed the finishing blow on him. Amazing cutscene, isn't that? I do not understand. How? I am big and strong and next to you. Next to me, you seem so puny. I shall now retreat and inform Sir William de la Pole that his brother is dead. What, Alexander is dead? Oh yeah, he killed Alexander, didn't he? And as for you, blast it. Start to count the days till we meet again, for that day will be your destruction. I shall await your arrival on that day. That guy runs funny. Crush a battle mace. Okay, let's give this to Laire then. Laire, I have a new weapon for you. Here we go. Put that thing back where it belongs. Okay, just give me a moment there. Okay, let's continue then. Actually, we can probably pick up that gold over there. Probably should not have done that, but over. Short work have been made of these guys.
Don't go away.
I'm guessing my generals aren't dying also because they have now reached a stage where they're not that weak as they originally were. So I suppose this game does actually get easier with time. Like the learning curve is in bruise. The difficulty curve. Wait, are there archers or something here? I don't know what's going on. Hey, you guys head in there and deal with those bastards.
We need to save our lands, not stand idly by.
I have not given them any commands yet, right? Good, good, good. Really not.
Don't bother hitting me. Critical attack. Critical attack.
I need help to fend off the enemy.
What the fuck are you guys doing there? Attack them!
Don't go away.
Critical kill. Don't bother getting up.
Don't go
critical
away.
Thank you. Come on, the other side first. Oh, there are no folks on the other side. Nothing in here either. Come on, move. Don't block my way.
Don't go away.
Don't bother getting up.
Am I stuck in here? Almost. Finally. That is not a fresh crossbow. Good. That guy took so long to lose his shot. That is a crossbow, so a sentinel crossbow. Best balance among range, defense, and rate of fire. Let's give this to Loire. Not that. I'll just leave the Duke of the Bastard of Orleans out there for now. Right. Loire, here we go, a new crossbow for you. Keep that in your inventory. I'm not gonna quick save yet because I think we have rid the area of everybody that could have been rid. So stairs make the enemies glitch, that's for certain. Now, I would actually like to give the Bastard of Orleans something. Let's give them a chicken leg. Give me a chicken leg first. And Bastard of Orleans, here you go. 2 pieces of bread for you. Why don't you go ahead and consume them? Get your health back to full again. Or was it ham? I forgot. It doesn't matter really. Okay, so Joan of Arc has a prison key. That is good. You're under me, come. We shall ride unto battle to die a glorious death at the hands of the English infidels. Well, they're not exactly infidels, they are Christians, but just not the kind that we're used to, you know. Right, FPS mode.
At your command!
Following General!
Yes?
Good. I'm guessing there are still a few people left in the area, being the reason.
Don't
why none of us are able to have captured, like, we haven't captured the city yet. I sort of dislike the way it was handled in the Siege of Chateau. Look at Loire and its full circle attacks. Just swinging that thing for all of its worth. Okay, so let's just scan for enemies here. If we can find any, that is. I see another contingent right here. Ooh boy.
Don't go away.
Don't go away. You're yet to die. Okay, fine. Joan of Arc does so. Joan of Arc, you're on me, yes? I hate that.
Yeah. Ready! Following general!
Actually, you know what? Let's just... Shift leadership to the ear now. I feel like, Well, he tasted his food and it was beetle. Cool. Is that guy not dead yet? Yes, cool. Not that. Okay, everybody. You know what, I'm just gonna do this.
Ready to comply.
Following general.
That was everybody. I'm guessing there are a few more enemies here. Unless that, considering the enemies near the gates there. It tells me that there are enemies here, but I cannot see any of them. Which is like the real, really strange part. I do believe there were like a few enemies nestled away around here somewhere. Towards the back of these here walls. No, that was just this side. So the entire city has like this ring-like structure. I'm guessing the only enemies remaining at this point are near the very beginning. You really need to loot. Oh, right. Those are the defensive towers, so we probably need the siege machines that the Bastard of Orleans brought for that, huh? Can't exactly eliminate those without the help of those machines there. And the worst part about it all is the fact that we can't exactly... rescue any of these guys without... Where are you wandering off? Where did you come from? I fear I may have taken the wrong path. No, it is the correct path. Okay, now I need to command the siege machine to move so that it can take out the defensive towers here. Okay, all four of you. Come here.
At once.
That is tough one for you. I'm guessing that the parts that they are taken were too small. Being the reason why they couldn't come all the way there. Because I honestly can't see any more enemies. I think we have defeated all of them. Look at those guys. They have no idea how to proceed, do they? They're a total goddamn mess is what they are. Okay, what we need you to do next? Okay, I can almost see. Yeah, let's...
At once!
Actually, let's bring you there. Yeah. They'll figure out a way to get there. In the meantime, we should head there as well.
We've got a job to do.
Come, my friends. Let us head to the castle walls as well. Maybe we shall decimate the enemy. Can't head through there. That way is blocked. This way is blocked. I suppose we take the narrow alleyway then. Could have just taken the inner road, but oh well. And this is where it says that there are some enemy troops right here. But I do not believe that for one bit. For I cannot see any of them. Is that a prison there? I'm curious to see. If it is, we might as well release some of the prisoners, huh? Oh, of course, I can't access it from this side. That is a prison that we have to access from the other side instead. This game. I swear, it can be a total pain in the ass. Meanwhile, I'm just waiting for the siege cannons to come here. Anytime now. Take your time. There's absolutely no rush. None that we know of anyway. Joan of Arc. Come. You need to release these prisoners. Merci beaucoup. You have returned my freedom. Okay, everybody here.
There's a country to be saved.
At your order, Owen General.
I hate that I have to do that every single time. These guys are now almost stationed at the very front, or at the very entrance of the damn place. You guys just had to take the thinner way around, didn't you? No, you don't. You guys don't really need to do that. Just come along and I'll show you what you guys need to do. Those guys seem to be stuck. Oh well, doesn't really matter.
Ready to comply.
Why don't you target this tower?
For France!
Yes, for France. And why don't you...
Ready!
For France, target
yes,
this tower here. Hopefully they'll be able to move out of that position that they've dug themselves into. Yeah, they can. Good. I think you can man the arbalist there, son. You.
Ready.
Man the arbalist. Why don't you?
Manning siege weapon.
Not exactly a siege weapon, but okay. Now let us watch these war towers crumble to dust. Where's the third one? Is it there? Yeah, these guys are stuck, aren't they? No. You guys need to come here first.
Ready.
Get over here.
Mobilizing to location. Ready.
You guys too. Come here first. And
mobilizing
then
to location.
We'll Ready. Figure out what to do with you. Yeah?
Yes, General.
These guys are on their way, which is a good thing. Or rather, no, they're just still stuck
Ready.
There.
Mobilizing to location.
Yeah, get there, come on. Oh, are you stuck? Really?
Mobilizing to location. Mobilizing to location. Mobilizing to location. Mobilizing to location.
Oh well. You did your best. Or so
Ready.
I suppose.
Mobilizing to location.
Good job, very good.
Yes, General.
Now why don't you get rid of that tower over there? Is this tower not destroyed yet?
Cannot attack target.
Why not? Okay, so... I guess these two obelisks are dead right now.
Ready.
I wish there was a way to unman these things.
Ready.
Okay, that's one target down.
At once. Ready. Yes, General.
Let's see if that works. Let's hope that that works. And that we do not have to get any infantry, light infantry, to come and attack this place again. That good effect on target. I can't see the cannonballs flying at them anymore. Oh yeah, I saw that. Are these guys just that effective at killing the troops off? I wonder. Almost down.
Cannot attack target.
Really? But you are attacking the target. Come on, just a little more. You can do it.
Ready. At once.
Hey, keep attacking it. Why do you stop? As soon as we're done with the star, we can...
Immediately! Ready! Cannot attack target!
Of course you can. Oh no, your button there is
ready.
Dead.
Ready! Ready! Ready to comply! To the attack!
Okay. So I guess we're gonna have to find some more troops for ourselves, because that certainly did not work. Probably should have stood in front of them. You there. Yes, you.
Ready.
The ear.
We
the
are fully manned.
Yes.
Ready.
Now then, attack this
yes,
target.
General.
And destroy it. It'll only take like one or two more hits before it goes out, honestly. If that. Let me see if I can find some more people there. Yeah, one of them has actually died, unfortunately. This is a mess, this is a mess, this is a mess.
Feast on this.
Unfortunately, I can't exactly deal any damage to this using my hammer. And definitely not using the explosive arrows that I have at my disposal. Not that that is of any use anymore. I guess my only hope right now is... Okay, so this has finally been destroyed? No. Something happened.
Well done. We seem to have the enemy on the run. Keep up the pressure.
Capturing Beaugency will be much tougher, men. The northern pass may be blocked, but there's a southern route we can take.
Yes, we can.
Indeed, the southern approach is far more accessible, closer, and there are reports of a small French town in the vicinity.
A small French town near Beaugency?
Perhaps they have items that we can acquire to help us lay siege to Beaugency.
What are we waiting for? Let us move swiftly and vanquish these scoundrels!
I am the bearer of good news, Methany. With two castles redeemed, we are witnessing the decline of our enemy's morale firsthand. Not only have English units fled Beaugency, but the gaffer is also gone.
Outstanding news! Fredon de Bras! Without the gaffer present, they cannot repair the damage we create on Beaugency. Now we can whittle away at its defenses until they yield.
That is the hope. That is the hope. Now, before I commence siege on Beaugency, as these guys like to call it, I would first like to go ahead and, you know what, let's just pick up the Duke of Alencon and see if, yeah, we cannot really make anything. Because we've only got 2,000 pieces of wood, and one of these things costs like 8,000 wood. Oh well. Alright. Let's switch back over to Joan of Arc.
Come on! There's a country to be saved!
At your order!
Hello, in general!
Let's go all the way over to the very end. And oh shit, we still do need like two folks to man the siege weapon, right? Well, that is a little sad because where will we find the folks to man the siege weapon? Oh, we could like totally hire some folks from Meung itself. I totally forgot about that. Sorry, my bad. I'm needing 6 infantrymen and light infantry. Let's make that 9. Cool. And the rest in heavy infantry. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right. So let's get 6 heavy infantry and 6 crossbowmen. But they don't really have a lot of good defense, to be honest. Let's get bowmen instead. We've got billion of gold, and let's have them come out and line up. Following which, we will be heading back to everybody ready?
Ready cool. To comply.
Following General.
Good.
Ready.
Man
we
it.
Are fully manned. Ready. Manning siege weapon.
Ready.
Dreadnought, perform work quick. Dreadnought, perform work quick. Dreadnought, perform work quick.
Ready.
Immediately.
Cannot execute command. Cannot execute command.
The verse shall the fuck in. She was supposed to be somewhere right there, but this is where it says that she is, but let's
at once.
Let's just have them come here first. We'll take things one step at a time. Have we manned this then? Good, they're coming as well.
Ready.
Okay. You can come here and you can join your friend right over here.
Mobilizing to location.
Good. Now that that's done, let us
ready.
Have you.
Bendo, perform work quiz.
Ready. Manning siege weapon. Ready. Manning siege weapon. Ready.
Ready. Ready.
Ready.
No, that's the boss of all means.
Ready.
Ready. Ready. Ready.
Is there like one guy that's stuck here somehow? No, that's just an item. I wish there was a way to move the map, but like rotate it, but there isn't actually. So which is the saddest part of it all?
Ready!
I thought I had gotten enough infantry, to be honest, but apparently I did not.
Mobilizing to location.
Ready. We need more units.
No, you do not. Stop lying. Did I like forget or leave some guys there? I feel like I did. It's strange because from this angle I can hardly tell. I cannot see any more troops right here. French heavy infantry. Come on, recruit.
At your command. Yes, General.
Are actually coming all the way here.
At once.
And then you're manning the siege cannon. And then we'll all be following. Oh, there you guys are. I see. I see what's going on.
Ready to comply. Immediately.
I was wondering what's going on. It all seemed pretty strange to me, you know. Okay.
Ready.
Since you're here.
Manning siege weapon.
Go man it. Are you not gonna man it?
Ready. We are fully manned.
Good.
Ready.
Exactly what I wanted to hear. Now then.
We need to save our lands, not stand. Mobilizing to location.
Okay, rest of you.
Yes?
The rest of you are on me. As soon as my frame's doing that is. I was about to say they seem to have returned, but not really, no.
At your command!
Following General!
That is Joan of Arc, right? Oh, that is Joan of Arc.
Following General.
We've got a job to do.
Ready.
Let's do it.
Following General.
That is Jean de Metz.
Ready to comply. Yes, General.
Can only command a maximum of 9 units. Assigning the selected...
Cannot
no,
perform request. Units reassigned to my command.
Cool. Well, he's more or less stuck there. The biggest issue is that we cannot.
Yes.
We can never really. Jean de Metz, are you following? Good. We could most definitely use your help, Jean de Metz. Cool then. Why do I see like a huge blot in the center over there, is what I want to know. Probably the guy on the arbalest, I believe. Yes. Cool. Preparations are over. Time to lay siege to Beaugency. Beaugency? Yes, Beaugency. Okay, you guys. You need to come here. Clear the path for them. Before I commence the attack on the damn city, I sort of want to try building another siege weapon on the other side and seeing how that goes. Pretty sure we'll have like a couple of boss fights here as well, but just give me room there. Okay, Falconer and Cannon. Alright, mobility attack. 4,000 iron. We can only make a maximum of 3 anyway. 3 of these or 2 of these? I guess I'll go for 3 of these instead.
Building siege weapons. Siege weapons built. Siege weapons built. Siege weapons built.
He said that thrice. I've got no idea why. And they've actually started the offensive. Okay.
Ready. We are fully manned. Ready. We are fully manned.
Okay. Where are the other siege weapons that I built? Oh, okay. Back there.
Ready. We are fully manned. Ready. Manning siege weapon.
In every mannerism of the word.
Ready.
Well, that's the bastard of Obit.
Ready.
Alright, every man here needs to follow.
Ready to comply. Unable to comply.
Following general.
Not what I wanted to do. My god. Why is it all so difficult?
Following general.
Yes?
Sorry about that. This game is just obtuse on purpose. Most of the time. I thought I saw gold here. Ah, right there. They are now crushing through the gates, which is amazing, to be honest. They got 2 cannons and 2 falconers. They breeze through the defenses. If we lose the control of... If we lose Beaugency, the control of the Loire region will revert to French hands. This will allow them safe travel throughout South Central France, and 100 years of struggle will have been in vain.
We have managed to breach the southern entrance of Beaugency, but I fear there is a more difficult task ahead.
Yes, there sure is.
Take heed, soldiers, and be wary of range attacks. Our armor would not stop the piercing arrows of the archers atop the walls of Beaugency.
That is true.
They could strike from north or south.
So the first order of business is probably going and eliminating all the archers. Is what I feel like would be the first order of business. Alright, I'm just gonna try and get some of these guys here to man some of the...
Ready.
Why are you chilling there? Come here. Why, I think you managed to, like... Yes, why don't you come here? The Falconer has been destroyed. And some of you guys are still hiding behind
Ready.
Her.
At your command.
Yes. Come here and man this Falconer. Falconer, apparently.
We are fully manned.
Yes, and... I'm pretty sure they can follow suit. Well, we needed them to destroy the gates, and the gates have been destroyed. So I suppose that is a successful mission there. I guess we will need to use Lair for this next section, because he's the only one with explosive bolts. This place has no... Okay, time to... I believe it's time to ignore all of these guards and just go for the kill atop these... Atop the stairs. Yeah. Okay, so here's what we need to do. We essentially just ignore all of these people and head straight for the back gates. We can head for those gates or we can head for these gates, but this is essentially the main gate that we want to head for. The rest are just filler. We can keep picking up these guys later.
This door must lead to the inner walls of Beaugency. Let us enter and seek out the enemy's overseer.
Lord Talbot. If we allow the French to claim possession of Beaugency, we will lose control of Loire, and all we have fought for will be naught. My lord, I will ensure it will not happen. Strike to kill men, destroy the enemy. What do you try to do otherwise, I wonder? I'm waiting for you guys to come here, really. Good. Lair, come. Smash through these gates. So the thing about Lair is, it does not matter how hard you hit, it's just the amount of hits really matters. And try to aim towards the center of the gate, hit both gates at the same time. And here's like an additional task for us. We need to make sure that our troops are mostly unmolested. Mostly, I say. Because it's fine if they're molested a little. Now, we need to make sure that Lord Talbot is not able to kill every single person here. And that includes micromanaging everybody. So, if you see anybody's health dropping like this, you better feed them stuff. Because if in this level, there are a few important people. I'll leave them lying there.
I'm being attacked.
Okay, Lord Talbot. Okay, that was the last of my explosive arrows. Saving here because we had some progress.
I really need to heal my wounds.
Okay, this guy's almost dead, so we need to give him something to eat. Let us have you eat this, and let us give this to you. Good. Let us have you eat that. We'll save your food for later. Why don't you have some apples and replenish your energy? You really don't need the apples. I'll give these to you. And one of them to Joan of Metz? No, Joan of Arc. She's the person who can use it the most. I'll give this to the Duke of Alencon because, yeah, he is totally... He does not have any health resources either. Health is pretty thin for the most part, but...
Taste my foot.
How did that foot taste?
I need help to fend off the enemy.
I'm being attacked!
Okay, Jean de Metz, you need to eat. Good thing I shared some food with you. You too. This guy will soon die. But until he does... I mean, the good thing about this guy is he only attacks linearly right in front of him. So... in most cases... I'll just wait for his attack to end. Done. So does this game have like a 3-strike system where 3 defeats means a death? This is the second time you have defeated me. Do not count your victories yet, for we shall meet again and I shall have lost laugh. If you say so. Okay, so I'm gonna come back. Okay. Where the fuck is the bastard of Orleans? Oh, sorry, I did not read that out. Okay, so Bastard of Orleans is almost dead, and we need to make sure that he's alive, which is a crucial mistake that I made the previous time around. He died, so to speak. Not so to speak, he did die, period. Cool. Now, what weapon is that? Orleans sword. Oh my god, that just looks fancy. It sucks, doesn't it? Okay, Bastard of Orleans, you're with me. So here's how we're gonna play this. Now we can actually take these guys out from here as well. Loading the map, okay. We can take those archers out from here also, but what I really want to do is to get up the stairs. The stairs are over here. Right over there. Oh wait, we're headed the wrong way. No wonder. Everybody's being impaled by like a hailstorm of arrows. Well, we thought that it was a good idea to lay siege to a city like this. I've got no idea. But this is where we have to go, essentially. I'll just save here. Since everything seems fine thus far, those are the stairs that we need to take to get upstairs. You guys are with me, right? Oh, right. I totally forgot. I just love disguise abilities. This guy's literally a tank. Just look at him. The way he can just plow through enemies like that. Tell me of just one other person who can do that, do something remotely close. And I shall, you should call me impressed.
Taste my foot. Taste my foot.
That's pretty much all I want to do, just go around and get as many of these archers as I can. Okay. I quickly want to just get everybody following him. Apparently that's too much to ask for. Holy shit. It's like the entire party is right here. The entire party using explosive arrows, that is. And here we are, trying to get all of them. I see where you are, you little sneak. Hey, I found a bun.
I need some help here!
Now that those archers are dealt with, I think we can head back for now. And rejoin the group. My god. That is hectic. Apparently these guys are fighting some kind of battle. Okay, so come with me. You should not be staying out of the open like that.
Critical attack.
Physical kill, apparently. So, it's so much easier to deal with these guys now that all the archers are dead. Okay, come. We need to climb back up the wall.
I really need to heal.
This guy does not have any health either. A shot of meds, I mean. Well, I don't know what use he is, but he does not have much health. I can share this with you. So, eat, Joan. Eat and stay alive. Now come to me. And I shall show you how to use arrows. To turn the tides of war into your favor. Any single person dies in this level, it's a game over, is what I've come to discover. Like, we literally need to kill every single person in this level. Otherwise, it is a game over. Sean just died, and that was the end of the game for us.
I need assistance.
That is help when you need it.
Not that. We need to heal like both of these guys, and we have only one thing that to share right now. For you, I could probably share this fish with you, which you should totally eat. As for Joan, well, she has nothing left. I think she can hold out for now. The good thing about these guys is once you get into close range against them, there's not really a lot that they can do. Oh, some low spread. Where do you think you're going? Get over here. More people all along the walls here. I'll basically need to keep a close eye on the enemy forces. Exposable. Okay, let us keep you right there. Because you, sir, are a liability. And you'll be losing health shortly. Let's keep this guy here as well, because he too is sort of liability.
I need some help here!
Where is Loire? You know, I've got no idea where. No wonder he needs help. He's not even on the same planet. If only you could have stuck with the program, you would not need all that much help, you know? Bastard of Orleans, where the fuck do you think you're going? Section is frustrating. Primarily because I've been having to retry this again and again. And I thought I told that death state, but then I guess I must not have done that. You'll have your health. Don't you worry about it. Maybe let's give you this and have you eat it and have you stay right where you are. And yeah, why don't you go ahead and consume that? It will be healthy for you, right? Bastard of Orleans, you need to start moving again. Okay, Bastard of Orleans,
stay in position.
You're a liability, Bastard of Orleans. You know that? Now we have to fight without any help because of your incompetence. Never should have brought you along for this raid. Good bastard, you say right there. Let us go ahead and clean this wall by ourselves. The way we can easily do it. This guy's arrows are powerful. I don't know how, but this guy's arrows are powerful.
Taste my foot. Feast on this.
This guy got leveled up, which is good.
Critical kill.
Like, the ear seems to be tanking all of these guys on his own. My god. That is insane. That is literally insane. Come here. Now, when did Lee's sword become that powerful is what I wonder. Why am I stuck here?
Critical attack.
Stop tanking hits.
Critical attack.
Okay, does she have any health? Yes, she does.
I need assistance.
Yes, Shantamets. Why did you run into battle all by yourself? Of course you need assistance. Where do you think you're running? There's no escape for you. You ought to know that by now. We have slowly managed to clear out all the enemies in this area. Except for some perhaps on top of these minarets here. That is what I'm headed to clear out right now. apparently not. 5 explosive bolts. Something on top of that mineral as well. I would like to know if I just did like a whole loop around the entire premises here. I do not have the means to carry that, so I'll just leave that be. Of course, Sir William Gloucester, the French think they can just waltz into our territory and walk away without a care in the world. Well, men, we'll have to show our guests the way out, won't we? Men, storm the castle! I want to see that maid's head on a platter. And I, my dear friend Sir William Gloucester, will help see you your wish fulfilled. I, too, will enjoy seeing the scourge of our Magnus burnt on a stake. We must not allow Beaugency to capitulate. The future of this war is at stake. Charge,
men. Sir Glasdale is rushing into the castle. It seems that we are outnumbered this time. What are we going to do?
Fear not, brothers in arms. I have answered your prayers. Lead the way, and I shall let us expel these foul English and rid us of their stench.
Okay. First off. Yeah. I'm gonna go up there and I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure that she's not moving from her place. Good. Now for number 4. Actually, let's just use this route here. Much far better route, to be honest. Oh yeah, totally forgot. This guy can redistribute some bread among these two. And this guy just indiscriminately provides all of these folks with bread. I sure hope Chantometz is holding position and isn't just moving all willy-nilly into the field of battle, no matter how brave it might be. Metz is on the forefront right now. Don't worry, Metz, I'm coming to your rescue. Because what else would I do?
Don't bother getting up.
Yeah, you guys can...
Don't bother getting up.
My health is waning, men.
Yeah, who told you to head straight into the fight then? Tell me that. You guys are literally getting mowed down by... Okay, safe thus far. This is the only strategy which has like even a remote chance of working out. So I'm just gonna keep sticking to it.
I need some help here.
Okay. That's like 3 entire bosses that you have to deal with. Lair, be careful. Be very careful. Jean de Metz, that is not your position. Back the fuck off. Jean de Metz, get the fuck back here. The ear is almost dead. What the fuck are you doing, John the Bats?
Critical attack.
You're a dead man.
She's getting double teamed by Foxtail Millets here. Okay. Lord Scales, my campaign has fared poorly. I will be returning to our camp at Shanville immediately. Cool. Be French. Good. Alright, Lair. He needs some food. Jean, you do have assorted fish. What about the Duke of Alencon? I don't know who to... Cool.
The health is waning, men.
That is not what I wanted to do at all.
I need help.
This is what it has come down to. I could find no solution. Sort of saved at a very inconvenient time there. Probably should not have done that, is my bad, but I'm willing to play this entire section all over again. So what I did was I looked up some cheats. And what I'm doing instead is I'm just cheating right now. I've turned on invincible mode just to get through this boss fight. Because no matter, I tried it on 15 to 20 times, and no matter what I did, all that I ended up doing was my men and I have experienced a severe setback. I must return to camp. Cool. So the issue right now was, because of the way that the bosses were positioned and the point at which I could see,
you're a dead man.
As soon as I was loading up the game and taking like 2 or 4 steps using any character, I was reaching the stage where one of my characters was dying. So right now I've turned on invincible mode, and what that does is essentially turns off hit registry for the weapons, for the enemies. So if the enemies hit you, it does not count as an enemy hitting you. And as sad as it is, well, I was sort of unwilling to retry the entire mission all over again just to do the section.
I shall prevail.
I mean, I sort of dug myself into that predicament, but it's fine. Especially since we're at the very end of this mission anyway. And there's not really much to it apart from this entire combat mechanic. So we might as well stick to what we can accomplish. Excuse me there.
Feast on this. Taste my foot.
No, I don't like to cheat, but I honestly believe that if the game is too difficult for you, go ahead. If you really want to play it, go ahead. It does ruin the entire experience of the game, to be honest. But in cases like these where you just can't progress, might as well go ahead and do it. Blast! I've been forced to retreat to our camp. Cool. Okay, quick save now.
Sir William Glasdale is retreating and is heading north towards Janvi.
Just 1 second. I'll just finish this game with the cheats enabled, and primarily because we have no food resources and everybody needs to stay alive. And no matter how much you tell them to just stay put, they will always find a way to just get back to, like, get moved towards the enemy instead. Trampled by ranged archers at this point in time. Actually, you know what, let me just go ahead and take care of the ranged archers first. I've got no idea where our support is. Of course, it's going to load the map right now. Oh, more firearms? Huh, interesting. Invincibility mode, I think about it as the fact that
my foot. Feast on this.
It does not give you infinite ammo or whatever, you still have to do most of the things yourself. There are just like a certain few things that you can delegate to your friends instead. Yeah, he said. You guys though. I should really level up her dexterity. Because she's literally knocking people over before she manages to kill them. Which is honestly the biggest pity. So, I'm guessing there are like still a few enemies left. Such as these ones here. Oh, right. It just makes it so that you won't die. Now, if I did not have to save all my friends, I would not really have turned on this sheet, but, well, I sort of do have to save, make sure that everybody survives out. This mission is an instant failure, so, yeah, that's pretty much the issue at hand right here.
Feast on this.
So what am I supposed to do now? I thought we already defeated them.
Feast on this.
The Beaugency capture. Duke of Alencon, I've got a weapon for you. Of course you're gonna carry it. You're carrying arrows for somebody else. How would you be able to carry it? Like, as you can see, nobody has any food whatsoever. No way to heal themselves.
Feast on this.
Any enemies down here? Could be, you never know. Duke of Alencon is literally has like an attack contingent on his tail. Easier.
Feast on this. Feast my foot.
I love the Duke. I love this guy's moves. Pity that he's so slow though. He's literally like a guy who's supposed to just eliminate the entirety of the foe. Like, get in this in the middle and just wreak havoc on them. Now, I don't think there are any enemies here, but I'm just gonna go ahead and check. Nonetheless, too bad we don't have any arrows. Well, the cavalry is inbound, and they will be captured soon enough, so don't you worry about that. I guess they didn't need to. This is like the worst part of the game, where you literally need to find and eliminate every single one of the enemy combatants. So which one of you is actually using the explosive arrows then? You're the last man alive and you still want to defend the city, huh? Well, actually you were not the last man alive. Among the last men, but not exactly the last man. Stabbed him at the back, but he still... Not a single reaction. Not a single reaction.
I'm too fast for you, dead man. I'm too fast for you, dead man. I'm too fast for you. I shall prevail.
Anybody else?
Ready? Following, General.
That's your voice? Holy shit. It is already night time. Clean the Beaugency. And that is why we're here. To perform cleanup tasks.
I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man. I'm too fast for you. I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man. I'm too fast for you. I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man.
Where do you think you're going? Of all the mundane tasks to be done. Why don't these guys just surrender already? Like, do they really have to start a fight?
I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man. I'm too fast for you.
Really gonna...
I'm too fast for you. I'm too fast for you. I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man.
Whew. What's this? Destroy all siege weapons in the camp. I see.
The stronghold is ours. We have successfully vanquished the enemy forces.
Yay.
Sir William Glass.
So what it is essentially asking us to do is... Oh, okay. Now we need to go and assault these camps. Why, man? Why? Why all this tedious business? Why make this game so tedious?
I'm too fast for you.
Cleaning up the water around there. Right. So, at this point, it's pretty simple. We ask these guys to rest here. And... So we're simply asking these guys to rest here now. Because the previous time round, we died.
see. I'm too fast for you. You're a dead man. You're a dead man. I shall prevail.
I feel like a string of fools. Yeah, a string of fools.
I'm too fast for you, you're a dead man.
I'm honestly so tired of playing this game at this point in time that I find it a little difficult to commentate. Yeah, we'll get you. Let me just go ahead and clean up the message in case. Including you, not including you.
You're a dead man.
Yeah, let me just go ahead and take care of this kind of thing.
No mercy!
I'm sorry, I have been keeping quiet for the longest time as well. That's because I'm just so goddamn tired of playing this game at this point in time.
I shall prevail.
I mean, without cheats, it's a pain. With cheats, it's just boring. I mean, why did they have to make this mission so long? Not only did we get like... What is the crowd of boss fights including this? In this game, I wonder. I think the count of boss fights is easily reached like 9 or 10 by now? Let us count. There was William de la Pole and Alexander de la Pole. Then there was that fat guy that puts it at 3. And then there was Lord Talbot, which puts it at 4. And then there was Glassdale, which puts it at 5. Then there was these two guys, which puts it at 7. And then there are these two guys again, which puts it at 9. Wounded I am and need to seek safer ground. Englishman, you shall kill these French miscreants where I failed. Of course. Run. And tell your underlings to do your job for you. Our work here is no more. The cause is lost, man. Let us retreat and help our troops with north. Go on then. Oh my god. Why is this so long? You guys literally have to know how to block. These things are strange, to be honest. Duke of Alencon has advanced to level 7 or something. That is apparently where we have to go. I don't know why, but that is apparently where we have to go. I'm not even gonna open these crates here. Yeah, it's too difficult to get to it. I'm not even gonna pay it any mind.
You're a dead man.
Come on.
You're a dead man.
Like, this game has no challenge. I don't mean that this game is not difficult to finish, or I don't mean to say that this game is easy. What I mean to say is that this game literally does not provide any kind of challenge. It's just annoying. That's it. Just a bunch of annoyance and then you're done. You won't really find anything else. You have liberated the town of Chandville from enemy occupation. But just to be extra clear,
I'm too fast for you.
Right then. Basically, to find and kill enemy units in the camp. One of the Duke's men is here. I wonder how. Hold on.
We need to save our lands, not stand idly by.
Yes, we're doing that. We are doing that. I really hope that we don't need to liberate all the villages as well. Because that would suck. Yay, we leveled up. Why are these missions so long? That was easy. Not for the last time, I suppose. Should be somewhere over here. Over here. Okay, this town is ultimately liberated, which is amazing. Now where are we supposed to head? It's telling me to go there for whatever reason. Oh, okay. I'm guessing that's where Sir William Glass sailors. Time for another boss fight. So this officially brings the boss fight count up to 10 in this level. 10 entire bosses.
Take that. You're a dead man.
Missed.
I shall defend.
I wonder how this guy came here. The Duke of Alencon's man. Well, it's only a matter of time before this guy gets pistachioed. Wait, who's? There you are. Didn't exactly leave a lot of pieces for yourself to run, did you? Let's see what's in this chest. A ring. Griffin Ring. Mythical Griffin Ring grants the bearer immunity against decreases in troop morale. Wearer will not be affected by drops in troop morale. Effects negated once HP and EP drop below 50%. Now see, stuff like that leads me to believe that they wanted to include like a morale mechanic in this game, but they never really got to it. Development time of this game was like 6 months, so I guess they had to pad it out with some other kind of content. I have failed this time, but my spirit is willing. You may have taken Loire, but I will never allow you to reach Reims with your king. Or Reim. I don't know how you say that. I scampered away from his camp. Without leave, the English are vulnerable. Now it is time to finish off the rest of them. Right there? Is what you're saying there? Moorings!
You're a dead man.
By all means, this level should have ended a long time ago. Why are there still battles being fought? Like, how long will you drag this level? My god. Learn to not oversee your welcome. Come on, that is the least you can do. I actually reviewed this game on Steam when I thought I got softlocked, and needless to say, I did not give it a flattering review. But after completing the previous few levels, like previous one level and coming all the way to this one, man, I feel like I underestimated how much of a pain this game is. I'm guessing that's it. There's nothing more to do. At least I suppose. So where am I supposed to go now? Mission brief. Battleground. A 2D view. So this is where we are. Okay, so there are only three more villages remaining. Might as well go ahead and do that then. Fine. This is one long level. I just hope that I don't actually have to, like, save all the citizens in Meung as well, because my god, will that be a pain. Okay, enough playing with that guy. I'm gonna play with this guy for some time. It's difficult to play this character after playing, you know, through the smoothness of that guy, Jean de Metz. Because my god, is playing with him smooth.
At your command! Yes, General!
Following General!
I thought I saw some ghouls here.
Come on, there's a country to be saved.
I know. Villages to be liberated, etc., etc. I wish I could share your enthusiasm about this game, but unfortunately, Joan of Arc, I do not. In fact, I find this game a pain to play, especially in instances like these, where it's totally overstaying its welcome for no cause whatsoever. Explosive arrows. I'll let you have those. Okay, understandable.
You're making me run.
Okay, you said. So, troops at your command will not be invincible. If you're using the cheat, I mean. They will be very invincible. If that is even a wood, which I doubt it is, meaning it's not. And I essentially made that wood up, but. Ooh. Crushed his head of the foot. Nasty. Excuse me there. Probably some guy right here. Nope. Wonder why I even climbed up there in the first place. Ah, I see. This guy is so slow. Why is this guy so slow? Why did I pick up this game? Why did I ever play this game as a child? I'm regretting my choices now. You know, there's like the stack of games which says choices matter. Well, choices most certainly do matter. I've realized that the hard way now. Where did you come from? And are you really gonna square up against four generals on your own? Impressive, impressive valor. I mean, if as long as this place is liberated, I guess we do not necessarily need to get this last guy either. Cool. Finally. Didn't need to do that though. Okay, new rule. We're all following.
Ready to comply!
Following General!
Yes?
The Duke of Alencon. My god. Why are these missions so long? Cool. Loading map. It's gonna load the map for this tiny little section here. Look at these shameless bastards. They all have like exploding arrows. And for what? That's nothing to the gameplay. Just makes things difficult for us players.
Don't bother getting up.
Don't go away.
Don't bother getting
in a game where the strategy does not really work out.
Don't bother getting up.
Don't go away.
Anybody got any more arrows? You seem to have some arrows. Might as well give them to that guy then. Give them to me for the time being, why won't you? Thank you. Look at that guy, armed with explosive bolts. Cool. No, this is the way we're headed. Again, why am I doing all this again? Because, oh yeah, I want to finish this mission. Like, my god, does this game not know when to end? Whew. Why? Who thought that this would be an entertaining way to spend time? like which guy who was directing this game or who playtested it said, man, this is fun to play. Are you guys still killing him? Okay, nice. I can't even see if there's a guy in there.
Don't go away.
I'm guessing they're dead. I wonder where these people keep coming from. Does not seem to be anybody in there. Okay, moving on. More enemies. Why? Let me just get to this village and liberate it and be done with this level. I do not want to play this level anymore.
Don't go away.
I have no idea for how many hours I've been trying this same level. But playing the same level at this point in time. I'll probably finally realize how long it has been once I see the length of my OBS recording.
Don't go away.
Pretty sure it's gonna be a long, long recording. Another boss? Lauren Scott, you meddling peasants. This land is of the rightful ownership of our King Henry, and you have just trampled across it uninvited. For that you shall pay dearly. Your bosses have said all of that, and they have all failed. Who are you to say otherwise? See, moments like these, I wish I was playing this that year because of this broad range of attacks. Just look at his attacks. You can literally enter like an entire group of enemies and destroy them from the core of the unit. Okay, who else? Some people here. Oh, I see. Alice, what's his name? Man called Alice. That's new to me, but oh well. If you say so. Not dead yet. Okay, where are the other enemies then? And how did you guys climb up there? That's the way up. Okay. Cool. Any more enemies left? I have no idea. This not seem to be the case, but you never know, right? One person apparently. One archer. Exactly what makes this game so tedious. Like, you literally have to find every single archer and defeat them. Every single enemy, you cannot beat even one of them. Look at the amount of archers that there are in this level. Why? Yeah, I'll let them deal with those guys. The Duke of Alencon also needs two creators. Well, bull for the most part. Okay, time for you to just die now, I guess. Okay, come on, die. Come on, get back up. I really have not got all day. Good part of this is that there is now a shortcut into Meung, which saves us like a ton of travel time. Not that it's anything huge, but there's a shortcut into Meung. Oh no, it's not Meung. It's all no. Holy shit. Okay, I'm tired of playing as this character now. Everybody present.
At your orders. Following General.
Come on. Yes? There's a country to be saved.
Follow Joan of Arc. Good. I'm not in particularly mind. Of course, you're going to load the map now. I don't particularly mind playing as the Duke of Alencon, but at the same time. His attacks are just a little too linear. They get tiresome very quickly. His attacks, I mean. And if need be, we'll find the final citizens in Meung and rescue them as well. Oh, right. The Duke of Alencon has our arrows. I'm still unclear about where exactly. Ooh, that is responsive.
The settlement of Montargis is under enemy occupation. Men, let's help the inhabitants rid themselves of the enemy threat.
Let's help the inhabitants rid themselves of the enemy threat? Did I hear that right? But Joan of Arc seems like a very balanced sort of playstyle. I don't really understand what Duke of Alencon is supposed to be. I mean, the ear is supposed to be clearly a tank. Shot of Metz is supposed to be the nimble character. There's nobody faster than him. Then there's yeah, and your way to victory, huh? Alright, with that done, I guess we're headed to Moon now. Okay, fine. We did not need to do that. You have successfully captured the castles of Moon and Beaugency. Congratulations on the total domination of the entire Loire River Basin. And for getting bored the fuck out of your mind. I took 3.5 hours of playtime on record. It would have easily taken far more than that. I'm pretty sure that my recording is like 4 hours or 4.5 hours long at this point. Holy shit. Sorry I had to use cheats at the end there, but I was totally bored out of my mind. And especially considering the fact that where I'd saved was probably the unluckiest spot for any person to save, and there was no practical way for me to continue. I just used cheats, and from there on I was just too fucking tired to play this game any further. This level definitely, very, very definitely overstayed its welcome. I don't know why or who thought that making such a long level was going to be pleasurable, but whoever it was, a sincere fuck you to you, sir. This was the most painful level of my life. My ass hurts from sitting on it for so long. Holy hell. I'm now afraid of playing the next 2 levels of this game. How long are those going to be? Holy shit. 9 total boss fights? Are you kidding me? 9 boss fights? What the fuck? Why did I even pick this game up? Holy shit. Anyhow, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. If you had the patience to stick around until the end, I for sure did not have the patience to play it through until the end. Until next time, when we come back to play Mission Impasse. Mission number 7, Impasse. Take care. Fare thee fucking well, Earthlings. Holy shit.